Story starts on a stormy night in a dark forest with battered researchers on the ground. Story also starts with you as the main character, known as a mercenary with no past records for the sake of convenience and endowed with a gift of vague storytelling. Episode 1, The White Mage. Grizzly seen-it-all veteran, you, tells the audience of a harsh reality of a corrupt world, but is then interrupted into escorting Hatsar's servant into Arian. Hatsar's servant tells you to see Hatsar for a reward. Hatsar then wants you to find the White Mage for money. Summary of the White Mage in 3 words. Smart, talented, and emo. Why is he emo, you ask? Because he's too smart and talented. No, really. I'm being serious. That's really the reason. I guess this goes to show you that even those who stand at the top aren't always happy and may want more. That's deep. Also, it may be a good first step to becoming the Black Mage from the White Mage. Spoilers. You decide to help because life is meaningless, and definitely not for the money Hatsar offers. Definitely not for the money. You end up at Ellen Forest and meet Fairy Queen Athenaeum in your search. She's a fairy, so she must hate humans and money. She hates humans and money. However, she does like the White Mage. After you gain her trust, Athenaeum tells you the White Mage is studying light in the darkest place, makes sense, in the Forest of Peace. 3 months later in the forest, you find the White Mage and he takes you to a temple where he talks about the meaning of life along with how deep of a person he is. 3 months later, you realize how terrible of a person he is. After connecting the dots purely based off of circumstantial evidence, you find out that he's the reason why monsters called omens have been appearing. After confronting the White Mage, he informs you that there's no light in the darkness, as it wasn't obvious, and destroys everything, which brings you back to where the story started. Stormy night in a dark forest with battered researchers on the ground. Upon following the trail of beaten down researchers, you're met by the White Mage. But because he doesn't have the white hair anymore and radiates evil, you decide to call him the Black Mage instead. Apparently this name sticks despite your very existence being unknown after your death at the hands of the Black Mage as the mercenary in the story. Oh right, almost forgot about a kid named Aaron you saved at some point in the story who follows you around. I don't know if she'll be alright in the forest filled with omens after you're dead. Good luck, Aaron!
Hey guys, thank you guys for watching our first episode of Grand Athenaeum in 2 Minutes featuring the White Mage. We're going to be having another video like this for each and every one of our Grand Athenaeum episodes. So stick around and we'll see you guys some more next time.